Knowing about today's news is vital to our everyday lives, and journalists are at the center of the news process, carrying on the shoulders the duty to find out the truth and let everyone know. How do they go about becoming journalists? What do they think about the profession?
在我实习的期间，第一次接触到新闻摄影这个行业，接触到大量的新闻图片，对我有很大的启发。
其实我觉得现在是一个资讯爆炸的年代，在这么多的时局、不同的事件里面，你怎样去剖析你的社会，是很需要一班有承担的知识分子去做的。透过读新闻系，入到电视台做事，我接触到不同的任务，四川地震、奥运都很具挑战性的。而且我感受到，做记者真的可以贡献社会，见到不同的事物，亦都可以终身学习。
Hong Kong Baptist University started teaching journalism in 1968 under the Department of Communication. When the latter became the School of Communication in 1991, a separate journalism department was set up. The department has nurtured many outstanding professionals throughout its 40 years of service. Every year, hundreds of secondary school students apply for our programs. We offer undergraduate degrees in international, Chinese, and broadcast journalism. Lecturers in the department come from different parts of the world and have wide experience as journalism professionals, researchers and teachers. The program has a basic theoretical element and also emphasizes journalism practice and experience. Students meet journalists in residence who visit us annually to discuss how things are done in the immense world of journalism. They share with students their experience as journalists and to shed light on different issues. Each concentration has its own students' workshop. San Po Yan, Broadcast News Network, and The Young Reporter, BNN does radio and TV newscasts for the HKBU campus and our website, and the other two do print and online newspapers. These workshops provide students with a first taste of the real world of journalism under the guidance of the staff. Students also get plenty of chance to go overseas. They gain experience of different societies and cultures, something which is essential to a journalist's learning. The Journalism Department gives out scholarships every year in recognition of students' hard work. The internship is the cornerstone of the practical side of the journalism program. Students are assigned to 2 to 3 month placement in the summer vacation after the second year of study. Not only do they get a chance to put their knowledge at work, but also face professional challenges.
今年嘅暑假，我同三個同學去咗柬埔寨一間叫做《Plum Pan Post》嘅英文報紙做實習，而當中一個比較有趣嘅經驗，就係我寫咗一篇關於當地人食藏文化嘅故仔。
喺呢一次經驗，我學識咗點樣克服言語嘅障礙，更加成功完成咗一篇報導，令到我自己覺得好有成功感。
我喺蘋果日報做咗2個月實習，咁一個月做特發，一個月做整態嘅。咁喺特發嗰陣時咧，學得最多就係咩叫即時反應，因為你會知道你就算慢1秒鐘都會錯過咗啲好緊要嘅嘢啦。
暑假嘅時候咧，我喺有線電視嘅新聞台做實習。 咁實習嘅期間咧，我就去採訪過一單謀殺案。咁我一邊要做街訪咯，另一邊咧又要兼顧事態嘅最新發展。咁其實對我嚟講咧，都有一定嘅難度。不過我知道咧，如果要做一個成功嘅記者，就一定要克服呢啲障礙。
2007, the journalism department began offering a master's degree in international journalism to nurture professional talent with a global perspective. We have experienced media professionals among our lecturers, and also working journalists from international media organizations to give talks and tutorials. Such journalists are joined by prominent members of the community such as Consul General and media administrators, who aim to give students an all-round knowledge of the local and global media. In 2008, we began to offer a concentration in business and financial journalism to prepare specialized students for that very important section of the media.
Pulitzer Prize Winners Workshop established in 2007 and has been held every year since then. The Pulitzer Prize is the most prestigious award in journalism in the US and is recognized all around the world. Many honorable guests attended the great event. The workshop were in some cases for our own students, but many were open to the public and attended by media workers and others.
And what would that look like? Photographers have been...
The event was well received and taken the journalism education in Hong Kong to a new phase.
made the whole world.
The mentor-mentee scheme was an innovation in journalism education. The department invited more than 30 media veterans to act as mentors to new undergraduates, giving them direct access to the profession and a way to learn outside the classroom what it's like to work as a journalist. More than 20 of our undergraduates went to Beijing in 2008 to report on the Olympic Games. They interviewed Yang Yang, the 500-meter and 1,000-meter short track speed skating gold medalist in the 2002 Winter Olympics. And she told them about how she felt when she became a champion. Security was very strict during the Olympics. We went to the International News Center and saw the facilities and newsroom. They also visited China's main broadcaster, CCTV.
第29届奥运会在北京时间8月8号正式揭幕，整个嘅开幕仪式顺利完成。北京国际新闻中心召开记者会。 邀请了负责设计和构思整个开幕仪式的负责单位出席。现场吸引了超过300名来自世界各地的传媒代表参与。Our
students went to Shanghai Expo for an interview in May 2010. They visited many pavilions and enjoyed cultures from different countries.
In January 2009, some of the students from MA in International Journalism Study went to New York. They visited the local finance and news agency. Also, some of them went to Prague for correspondent training program and communicated with the local media company and the university there.
The Taiwan presidential elections in 2004 and 2008 shook the society, and our students were there on both occasions to report on the vote. Our students went to the election forums to learn about the latest developments. The Kuomintang and the Democratic Progressive Party were happy to do whatever it took to triumph in the elections. Our students reported both the dramatic wins of Chen Shui-bian in 2004 and the one-sided competition in 2008, from which Ma Ying-jeou emerged victorious. In 2006, we became the first university in Hong Kong to be invited to the National People's Congress and People's Political Consultative Conference in China. More than 100 news organizations attended the press conference. Our student Chen Weiling raised questions, and it was answered by Jiang Enzhu, the secretary for the Standing Committee for the NPC. The students did their own reporting and had many stories published in Hong Kong. International journalism students went on a study trip to London in May 2008. They visited the Financial Times, the Guardian and the Times and had briefings from journalists. They also went to City University of London, where Britain's top journalism course is taught.
Put students first and inspiring future journalists are our commitment to the young generation. We will try our best to achieve journalistic excellency through innovation and whole person education.